How much time do you spend with your family? Well, the average amount of time American families actually spend together will shock you. And here to share some of the findings is a familiar face, if you love TMZ, married father of two, host of Hollywood Pipeline, Dax Holt. Dax, good morning to you.
Good morning. Thank you.
It's great to have you on. So we're talking about the amount of time that families spend together. You, of course, are a father of two. What are the findings behind this survey and this research?
Yeah, so this survey was actually pretty crazy, but Visit Anaheim did this whole survey. They polled 2,000 parents of school-aged children. Come to find out, on average, because people's lives are so hectic, so busy, a family on average has 37 minutes of quality family time per day. That's it. No more. You know, most people are spending time at work, on the road, doing other things, and so by the time they actually get home, that's it, 37 minutes. So, you know, I paired up with Visit Anaheim, and I'm telling people, come to Anaheim, because the way that I get to spend the most time with my family is on vacation. It's getting away. It's putting the job aside and going and really focusing on the family. And in Anaheim, there's so much to do for the family. I mean, that's really what the city specializes in. And so you've got Disneyland, of course, but you've also got the Great Wolf Lodge. You've got Knott's Berry Farm. You've got all these sporting activities. There's the Ducks. There's the Anaheim Angels. And aside from all the family activities, the other big thing that the survey pointed out was the fact that couples aren't getting enough quality date nights out either. On average, there's about 12 date nights a year. And so when you come to Anaheim, take one night and go out with your loved one. You know, I've got a couple recommendations myself, which number one is The Fifth, which is this really cool rooftop bar on a hotel that's across from Disneyland. You go, you sit, they pipe in the music from Disneyland, you watch the fireworks, you have drinks, and it's very romantic. By the way, I'll be there this weekend if you want to come out, because my wife and I are going. But there's also a really cool place called The Packing House, and it's a bunch of restaurants. They've got this place that you see right here. It's called The Blind Rabbit, which is a speakeasy behind a hidden door. You get in there, and there's mixologists mixing drinks for you. They're adding, like, cool fire, and that's an old-fashioned, I think, right there that they're making. It's just a really fun place to go. And, you know, I just gotta say, come to Anaheim. It's more than just Disneyland. There's so many things to do, and it's a way to really bond with your family.
Right, and I mean, that's a good reminder, because we spend most of our year working. As a parent, what would you tell other parents about how important it is to spend that quality time with your kids?
Listen, I don't think I have to tell other parents, because other parents probably know it just as well. You know, you get home and you're tired and you want to go to sleep, but you're like, your kids are sitting there excited to see you, because you're their life. They want to spend time with you, and that is the way you can do it. And if you don't, you know, if you're confused and you don't know what to do in Anaheim, go to visitanaheim.org. There's all the planning tools that you need there. They'll help you figure out the cool places to go, the fun places with your kids. There's discounts, all kinds of stuff to do on visitanaheim.org. Or, you know, I follow their Instagram account, because even though I'm an Anaheim resident and I do the staycation all the time, they're always posting photos, and I'm like, oh, I haven't been there yet. I want to go check that place out. So those are my recommendations. Go follow them, and they'll give you all these kind of fun, cool tips.
Right. Clearly, Anaheim, a great destination. I can't let you go without asking you what you think about the celebrity news these days.
Listen, I'm still deeply involved in celebrity news. I've got my own website now called HollywoodPipeline.com. It's very photo-driven. It's basically like TMZ and Instagram had a little baby, and it's called Hollywood Pipeline. And it's just all photos, videos. And so, you know, I can't get away from Hollywood news. I love it. It's in my blood at this point.
Right. It's definitely addictive. People love it. Keep doing what you're doing. And thanks so much for the great info on Anaheim.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Of course. Stay right where you are. We'll be right back.